From the second EPP, we did questions in which we related the current and drift velocity and all. I think some of the questions.
So could you explain that conductivity wala formula?
Conductivity wala formula?
Yes, sir.
This I think we derived. This we got from using the current density as J is equal to NEVD. NVD was E capital E by M into tau. So current density was I by A. I is NEAVD. And drift velocity we calculated as E capital E by M times tau. Now if you substitute here, NE into E tau by M into capital E. J, which is current density, is proportional to NE square tau by M into E. J is a vector quantity. And the direction of current density and electric field are in the same direction. J is directly proportional to E, electric field applied. So that becomes J is equal to sigma into E, where sigma is that constant defined as N E square tau by M. Is a constant called as conductivity of that material.
Thank you, sir.
The inverse of conductivity was resistivity, 1 upon sigma times J. 1 upon sigma is rho. So we got the formula for resistivity as M over N E square tau. And from here only we got that formula for resistance also. So V is equal to rho L by A times I, which proves the Ohm's law that under the same length, same area, and same temperature, potential applied is directly proportional to current flowed. Yes.
Yes, sir.
Any other doubt?
No, sir. Thank you.
Did we do the questions based on drift velocity from the DPP number 2?
We started doing some questions here.
Yes, sir.
Started doing only. Yeah, I have shared the remaining DPPs also from this chapter, but we were at second. Second was relation between current, drift velocity, J, and this one. We were discussing, I think we started just. Question number second. Did we do this last class? Aluminum wire having cross section area 4 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter square carries a current of 5. No. Okay. So let's do this. Assuming that one conductive electron is supplied by each atom, find the drift speed. It's a little better question because information here is given, but not directly. You'll have to figure out that information. Read the question. Which quantity we have to calculate? Current is given and we have to find the drift speed or drift velocity. And I hope you have solved SL Arora and there's no doubt. SL Arora questions also you have to solve. And you can bring those also in the class for doubts. Even in the regular class for the current topic, you can ask those doubts. Yeah. So the question says that there is a aluminum wire having cross section area 4 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter square carries a current of 5 ampere. Find the drift speed of electron. The density is given. So drift speed we have to calculate. Current is given. I is equal to small n e a v d. That is the formula we are going to use. Current is known 5 ampere. Area is known 410 to the power minus 6 e. Already we know. small m here is number of free electrons per unit volume, which is also called as free electron density. Number of free electrons per unit volume, also called as free electron density. How will we find out that? In this case,
can we use density to do that?
No, this is not same as density. So this density of aluminium is mass density. Mass per unit volume is given. Density of aluminium is 2.7 gram per centimeter cube.
So we can assume that for unit volume, we'll have 2.7 grams of aluminium, and then uske molar mass se divide karke we can get something.
We have to use something similar, but unit volume that standard we take is 1 meter cube. So the mass of 1 centimeter cube of aluminium is 2.7 gram. But we have to calculate the number of electron in unit volume, and unit volume is standard is 1 meter cube. So it will be 2.7 into 10 to the power 6 gram, because 1 meter cube has 10 to the power 6 centimeter cube. Aluminium atomic weight, how much is that? Atomic weight of 27 gram. 13 aluminium, 27. So if we divide by 27, these many moles we will get, which is 10 to the power 5 moles. So 1 meter cube of aluminium contains 10 to the power 5 moles. 10 to the power 5 moles of aluminium. And 1 mole of aluminium has Avogadro number, so 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 atoms. 6.022 into 10 to the power 28. Atoms. Now it says that each atom contributes 1 conduction electron. So the number of free electrons per meter cube will be same as number of atoms per meter cube, which is 6.022 into 10 to the power 28. That is the value of small n that we have to use in this formula. From the density, we calculated mass of unit volume. From mass, we calculated number of we calculated the number of atoms, number of moles. From number of moles, we got number of atoms, and from number of atoms, we get how many electrons are there. Right?
Yes, sir.
So small n is known, area is known, current is known. Now we can find the drift speed. I is equal to small n.
Could you go back to the previous page?
Yes. Vd is equal to I divided by Ne into A. Just need to substitute the value.
Done, sir.
Right. Next is question number. So find the answer. What will be the answer to this? Suzanne, understood this? Okay, quickly solve. Answer according to the book. Yeah, what's your answer coming? Yes. Did anyone got the answer?
One second.
Mehir?
Yes, sir.
What's the answer?
Sir, I'm still calculating.
Yes.
So 0.12 × 10⁻³.
0.13 mm/s. That's the answer. Yes. Yeah. Understood, everyone. Kriti.
Yes, sir.
Got it, sir.
Okay. Next question, question number third, it's already given that copper has 8.5 × 10⁻²/m³. So this is the small n value only. Here nothing needs to be done. A small n is given. Diameter is given, we can find area. Current is given, I is equal to NAVD. We can directly use this. We can directly use this to calculate the drift speed. Okay, this I think we did. Order of speed of electron is 2 mm/s. Mean reflection time is inversely proportional to t. Question number 7. Did we do this question last class? No, I don't think so.
Yes, I think we did.
We did this.
Sir, we did a similar question, not this
similar.
One.
Okay, solve this one. Question number 7. 2 magnet wires whose length are in the ratio 1:2 and resistances are in the ratio 1:2 are connected in series with a battery. The ratio of drift velocity of electron in the two wires. Yeah. 2 magnet wires whose length are in the ratio 1:2 and resistance are in the ratio 1:2 are connected in series. If they are connected in series, what does that mean? Their current will be same. So I1 is equal to I2, and we have to use this fact that their current is same to find the ratio of the drift velocities. Yes. So here it says 2 manganin wires whose length are in the ratio 1:2 and resistance are in the ratio 1:2. How do we have to find a drift velocity? Since they are connected in series, they will have same current. N will be same because they both are manganin. NEAVD is equal to NEAVD. N and E gone. So the ratio of drift velocity VD1 by VD2 is equal to A2 by A1. Right? Right? A2 by A1. Now, A2 by A1, we will calculate karenge because we know the ratio of the resistances, that is 1 by 2, and we know the length ratio is also 1 by A. Since both are same material, R is equal to rho times L by A. So we can use that to calculate ratio of R1 by R2 is the resistance ratio. R1 is rho L1 by A1. R2 is rho L2 by A2. Rho rho gone. It becomes L1 by L2 into A2 by A1. And that is equal to R1 by R2. R1 by R2 is given 1 by 2. L1 by L2 is given 1 by 2. So A2 by A1 is 1. If A2 by A1 is 1, so that means the ratio of drift velocity will also be equal to 1. They both have the same drift velocity. Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, similar logic based questions is question number 8th, 9th, and 10th. Okay. Eighth first. A conductor of length L is connected to a DC source of MFE. Length of conductor is stretched by keeping the. Leave the 8th for now. Maybe question number 9 first. We'll come to question number 8. First question number 9. 9 and 10 are similar to this last question. Question number 9 says, current flows through the given conductor, which of these quantities remains constant throughout the complete length of the conductor? Which of the following quantity remains constant? Current, current density, electron mobility, or electric field? Yes. Which quantity is same? Yaar ye to simple hai, isme time ko laga do. Which quantity will remain same?
Current.
Current.
Will it be current?
Will be current. The amount of charge that goes in, the same has to cross because charge remains constant. Current density will be changing because current is same and area is changing. Electron mobility will be changing. Electric field. Electric field. What about electric field? Will change or remain same? And if I say which will be greater in wire 1 or wire 2, it will be same or it will be greater. E1 is equal to E2 or E1 is greater than equal to or E1 is less than equal to. Yes. What about electric field and by which formula you found that? E1 is equal to E2 or E1 is greater than equal to E2 or E2 E1 is less than equal to. करंट डेंसिटी हमने कैलकुलेट कर ली. करंट डेंसिटी किसमें ग्रेटर है? J1 will be less than J2 because का एरिया बड़ा है. करंट डेंसिटी ऑफ वायर 1 will be less than करंट डेंसिटी ऑफ वायर 2. Now this current density will be directly proportional to electric field because J is equal to sigma times. Yeah. Drift field is different, drift velocity is different. So what about drift velocity? Out of 1 and 2, which one has a greater drift velocity? The question is clear, na? Ye question to khatam ho gaya. This is very easy. Current is same because the same charge has to flow due to the charge due to the conservation of charge. Now the second question is, these two wires, which one has a greater electric field or greater drift speed? So to calculate both, to compare both, we use this relation of J with VD and J with J drift velocity, current density is NEVD. N will be same because they both are same conductor, given the same conductor, material is same. E will be constant. So drift speed jyada usme hogi, jahan pe current density jyada hai. Smaller area, current density will be greater. So J2 is greater than J1, that means drift velocity also for the second wire will be greater than drift velocity of the first wire. So we use these two relations, J is equal to sigma E and J is equal to NEVD to compare. Right? Similarly, in question number 10, similar question, same logic, because they will have same current.
VDA will be greater.
VDA will be greater than VDB. Question number 11 is similar to the one that we did. Copper wire of density, diameter 1 millimeter carries a current. Instead of the electron density, the normal mass density is given. So we can find out by the similar logic. Question number 12. I think this also we discussed in question number 12. When we increase the temperature, the thermal velocity increases. How does it increase? Because it is the behaving like exactly like a gas particle, and gas particle has energy 3/2 kBT, where kB is the Boltzmann constant. So speed will be, thermal velocity will be directly proportional to root of temperature. Okay, the rest questions are similar on the same logic. I is equal to NEVD. Calculate the J and Electron moving through a wire has an average velocity that is very, very small, order of speed around 10 to the power minus 4 meter, because what will be answer to question number 15? What is the reason of drift speed being so small?
The random velocity.
Drift velocity is not random velocity. Thermal velocity is random velocity.
Sir, will it be suffers many collisions?
Suffers many collisions because electron is not free for movement. As soon as it starts moving, it will collide with any other electron or matter. Right. Okay. So next concept, now we'll do the resistance of a wire. Resistance of a wire formula we have derived, and in class 10th also you would have done. The resistance of any metallic wire is given as rho times L by A. Rho is the resistivity, or rho is the resistivity, L is the length, and length across which the current flows, and A is the area through which current enters. So a metallic wire resistance will also depend upon where the battery is connected, or across what length that area that current is moving. R is equal to rho L by A, where rho is resistivity or specific resistance of that material, L is the length, and A is the area. So L is the length across which current flows. So same wire, there might be different orientation by which we can pass the current, through which current flows. A is the cross section area through which current enters into the wire. Meaning that, like, suppose for example, if we take a cuboidal metallic block having dimensions as 's, A is the length, B is the width, and C is the thickness. Length is A, width is B, and this thickness is C. Now this wire, and given that resistivity of that wire is rho. Now, if you say the resistance of this wire doesn't make sense unless you specify between which point the battery is going to be connected. If it is going to be connected across these terminals, let's say between A and B, current enters through this area, and the length flows through a length of A. Now the current will be along this length. So resistance of this metallic wire across AB. We say that resistance is constant. Yes, it is constant, but obviously it will also depend upon the length across which the current flows and the area through which, if we change that orientation, then obviously the length for the current has changed. Resistance of wire between A and B will be rho. Length across which it is moving is A, and area through which it enters is B into C. Same logic, if suppose we change the positions, if we change the orientation from I'm not writing much theoretical description, that's clear from the diagram only. If battery is connected between A and B, the current will enter at A and will come out from B, and that area through which it is going in or coming out is B into C. That will be a rectangle.
Done, sir.
Okay, the same wire, now we have shifted the position of battery. It's between C and D. So let's say this is C and here it is D. The resistance of the same wire between C and D. So now the length across which current moves is how much? the resistance between C and D. Let's make it X and Y if it's confusing with C. The resistance between X and Y is how much? Rho? The length across which it flows is C divided by area through which it enters. That area is A into V. Right, rho into C by AB, rho into C by AB, right? Or tisra kya hoga? If suppose we have taken the position of the battery between the other face, between let's say these two, the front and the back, P and Q. What will be the resistance between P and Q? Now the current is flowing across here and that length through which it flows is C only. So now it will, no, this length is B. So now the resistance will be rho into B divided by A into C. Same wire, but the orientation has changed. बड़ा समझ आ गया दोनों में डिफरेंस क्या हुआ व्हाई देयर इज अ चेंज इन द लेंथ एंड एरिया बिकॉज़ ऑफ द लेंथ अक्रॉस व्हिच द करंट फ्लोस सो वी हैव टू लाइक टेक दैट लेंथ अक्रॉस व्हिच द करंट फ्लोस नॉट द एंटायर लेंथ सो सिमिलरली नाउ वी आर मेकिंग सम मोर लिटिल कॉम्प्लिकेटेड एग्जांपल्स सेकंड केस इज सपोज देयर इज अ हॉलो सिलिंड्रिकल वायर फॉर दिस हॉलो सिलिंड्रिकल वायर For a hollow cylindrical wire, inner radius is suppose small r1, outer radius is cap is r2, and length is l. This length is l. Inner radius R1, outer radius R2. अब इसमें भी अगर हम सिर्फ ऐसे बोलते हैं what is the resistance, then it is incomplete question. We have to specify how we are going to connect the battery. One method is this only, that across the ends we are going to connect. Resistance between A and B, resistance of this hollow cylindrical wire between A and B. A is at one of the cross section, B is on the other cross section. Resistance of the wire between A and B. It will be rho, length is L. How much is the area? Pi R2 square minus R1 square. That is the area through which current enters. That is pi R2 square minus R1 square. So this was simple. R is equal to rho L by A only. Rho is the resistivity without any change. But now suppose in this same wire, we change the orientation. The orientation is such that the wire is battery positive terminal is connected to the inner surface. And this is the second case of the same cylindrical shell or cylindrical wire. Hollow cylindrical wire, inner radius R1, outer radius R2, and length is L.
Could you go back to the previous slide?
I'm not writing much in theory, so if you are not able to understand any topic, any part, please ask it, I'll explain it again. See, this is the resistance calculation, but as we say that resistance is constant, it's a little tricky statement because resistance would be constant only when we check the resistance between the fixed point. If we change the orientation, the position of point have changed, then the resistance also will change accordingly. So in this case, the battery is going to be connected across the end, across the faces only. So current goes in by pi R2 square minus R1 square area. And it covers the length of L. Well, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Second case is, suppose if we connect a battery from inner to outer. Inner to outer as such, this is the cylinder, solid cylinder. It is hollow from in between. Now we are connecting battery. The positive terminal of battery is, the positive terminal of battery is connected to the inner surface like this. And the negative terminal is connected to the outer surface, somewhat like this. So current is entering from inner surface, inner shell, and coming out from the outer shell. The length is L, inner radius is R1, and outer radius is R2. Resistance of this hollow cylinder when between the inner surface and outer surface. You understood the diagram, the difference between the two? Pehle wale mein humne end pe lagaya tha direct. So in the previous case, the area across which the current flows was same throughout. Throughout this length, the area in which current is flowing is same. But now it is going inside through a smaller surface area of a smaller cylinder and it's coming out through the bigger surface area. So its current is going like this. Is this clear? Diagram is clear? Now we cannot use that formula rho L by A because the area through which current is flowing that keeps on increasing. On the inner surface, area is less. On the outer surface, area is increasing. And therefore, we cannot use this. Right? Ab hum kya kar sakte hain isme? What we have to do? What is the option we have? Integration. Integration karne ke liye pehle ek chota sa kuch hame banana padta hai, a very small portion. And then we need to integrate. सो अगर हम स्मॉल आर पे एक छोटा सा डी आर थिकनेस का शेल लेते, वी कंसीडर अ वेरी करंट विल बी सेम, दैट इज फॉर श्योर बिकॉज दे ऑल आर सीरीज एंड एरिया डज नॉट अफेक्ट द करंट, द टोटल अमाउंट ऑफ चार्ज गोइंग इन एंड कमिंग आउट विल बी सेम. We considered a thin spherical, thin cylindrical shell having radius small r and thickness is dr. For this small cylinder, first we find out the resistance and then we integrate. Yes, Suzanne.
Where is your phone?
Suzanne, you can mute yourself. Okay, fine. So in this case, what is happening? Now current goes in through a smaller area and coming out through the bigger area. So that formula was only for a uniform area. R is equal to rho L by A when the area is uniform. So we cannot do that. That is why we have to integrate for a smaller
video.
So what we did is we considered a smaller surface, a smaller cylinder of radius R. Consider a cylindrical shell of radius small r and thickness dr. Cylindrical shell of radius r and thickness dr. The resistance of this smaller shell, how much is that? Resistance of this shell. So, अभी इसमें जो करंट पास हो रही है वो कितने एरिया से पास हो रही है, कितने लेंथ से पास हो रही है? The current is going through this length and that length is dr. R is equal to rho into length dr divided by area and the cross section surface area of cylinder is 2 pi rl. We considered this shell of radius r, thickness dr. The current is going radially outward, so current is crossing this length of dr and it is entering through an area of 2 pi r. Isko ab hum kya karenge, we will integrate this rho divided by 2 pi l 1 upon r dr. This is constant, r is changing from inner shell to outer shell. Integrate to calculate both the sides, total resistance 0 to capital R dr. Rho upon 2 pi L 1 upon R dr and limit is from R1 to R2. So left side, this is dr integration. Dr integration is R is equal to rho divided by 2 pi L divided by 2 pi L ln R ln R and that
to will be from to previous page.
R1 to R2. None.
Yes, sir.
But I समझ में आ रहा है कि हम इसमें integrate कर रहे हैं. Why the previous case we didn't integrate? Because in the previous case it was always having the same area. The wire, now here it is changing. The wire goes through a smaller area but comes out through a bigger area. right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what is the integration of 1 upon r? Is ln r rho divided by 2 pi l ln r2 minus ln r1, which becomes ln r2 by r1. This is the resistance of that wire. Resistance of the hollow cylindrical wire having inner area, inner radius r1, outer radius. Similarly, second case is for a hollow sphere. Understood? So resistance calculate karne ke liye, we have to identify that where current is entering, how current is coming out. And then we will decide if the area throughout remains constant. Resistance of hollow sphere and having inner radius R1, outer radius R2. Andar se bahar ki taraf koi current ja rahi hai. The current is going from inner to outer. बैटरी कैसे लगाए वो थोड़ा हाइपोथेटिकल है, दैट यू जस्ट अज्यूम कि पहले हमने पॉजिटिव टर्मिनल से कनेक्ट किया है एंड देन इट इज टेकन आउट देन द सिलेंडर दिस द स्फीयर इज फॉर्मड सो देयर इज अ बैटरी कनेक्टेड बिटवीन द इनर एंड द आउटर सरफेस. नाउ बिकॉज ऑफ दिस द करंट दैट एंटर्स, करंट इज एंटरिंग थ्रू अ स्मॉलर एरिया एंड कमिंग आउट थ्रू अ बिगर एरिया. अगेन वी कैन नॉट यूज आर इज इक्वल टू रो एल बाय ए डायरेक्टली. Again, we need to first find out a smaller spherical shell and then we have to integrate for it. So at a distance r, small r from it, consider a spherical shell. Consider a spherical shell which has a radius small r and thickness dr. Smaller radius and thickness is dr. Now consider this small surface. So rho into l, r ka formula hota hai rho l by a. L here is that a very small length which is dr divided by area. Area is 4 pi r square. Consider a thin spherical shell of radius r, thickness dr, and integrate for it. Now to calculate the net resistance, rho is constant, 4 pi is constant. We need to integrate on 1 upon r square, limit from 0 to capital R, and from r1 to r2. Dr integration is r, 1 upon r square integration is minus 1 by r, limit from r1 to r2. So rho by 4 pi minus 1 upon r2 minus minus plus 1 upon r. The resistance will become rho divided by 4 pi R2 minus R1 divided by R1 R2. This is the formula for the resistance of the hollow sphere, inner radius R1, outer radius R2. इसमें और किसी तरह का connection possible नहीं है. If that resistivity is constant, then R is equal to rho L by. Sometimes the resistivity is also given as a function of small r. Function of small r, then rho has to be changed accordingly first and then integrated. Right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so एक और बचता है केस, वो भी कर लेते हैं. देन वी विल डू ऑल थ्री डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ सर्किट्स, रेजिस्टर्स, सिलेंडर्स, स्फीयर, एंड थर्ड वन इज सिलेंडर ऑफ वेरिएबल क्रॉस सेक्शन, एज वी डिड, एज वी सॉ इन द लास्ट क्लास, आई मीन लास्ट क्वेश्चन. थर्ड इज अ वायर ऑफ नॉन यूनिफॉर्म क्रॉस सेक्शन एरिया. Non-uniform, either increasing or decreasing, non-uniform cross-section. So it is increasing linearly, the area is increasing gradually, continuously. In a first surface where the current enters, the radius is R1, and the other side where current is coming out, that radius is R2, and length is L. Resistivity of this material is rho, and we have to find resistivity is yes. इसमें क्या करेंगे, अगेन वी हैव टू चूज अगेन अ वेरी स्मॉलर लेंथ. सो लेट्स से कंसीडर अ स्मॉल, एट अ डिस्टेंस ऑफ एक्स कंसीडर अ वायर हैविंग थिकनेस dx, थिकनेस इज dx, एंड रेडियस इज स्मॉल r. एरिया इज इंक्रीजिंग, वी कैन नॉट डायरेक्टली यूज द फॉर्मूला. सो कंसीडर अ स्मॉल वायर, consider a small wire of length dx, thickness, length means thickness is dx, and cross section and radius is smaller, at a distance x from one end as shown. X from one end as shown. So, existence भी ये छोटा सा जो हमने length ले लिया, resistance R is equal to rho into L divided by area. Area is pi R. Rho into dx divided by pi R square. R is the radius of that smaller surface, smaller shell that we have chosen. So which quality is variable here? X is also changing and L is also changing. The R is also changing. So हमें दोनों को एक दूसरे में चेंज करना पड़ेगा. So which means we have to find relation of R with X. Consider these two smaller triangles. This angle is theta. R minus R1 divided by X will be equal to R2 minus R1 divided by X. Please check. This is the value of tan theta for these two triangles shown. And we equated the value of tan theta in terms of small r minus R1. This length is small r minus R1 divided by X is equal to R2 minus R1, right? Small r comes out R2 minus R1 by L times X plus R1. So, अभी थोड़ा सिंप्लिसिटी के लिए उसको अल्फा एक्स प्लस आर वन लिख लेते हैं. वेयर अल्फा इज आर टू माइनस आर वन. अल्फा इज आर टू माइनस आर वन बाय एल. रो टाइम्स डी एक्स डिवाइडेड बाय पाई इनटू अल्फा एक्स प्लस आर वन होल स्क्वायर. दिस इज द रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ दैट स्मॉलर. Yeah, understood. अब इसको इंटीग्रेट कर सकते हैं. कैसे इंटीग्रेट ऑन बोथ साइड द टोटल रेजिस्टेंस. द टोटल रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ दिस वायर नाउ इट इज अ वेरिएबल ऑन एक्स. सो वील इंटीग्रेट एक्स फ्रॉम जीरो टू एल. इंटीग्रेट ऑन बोथ साइड सो इट विल बिकम जीरो टू आर टाइम्स बी आर रो बाई पाई dx divided by alpha x plus r1 whole square limit from 0 to n. Yes, please check if it is clear. Got it? बेटा ये समझ आ रहा है ना? ये अर्नव समझ आ रहा है?
Yes sir, थोड़ा सा मैथ्स ऊपर से जा रही है.
थोड़ी सी मैथ्स ऊपर से जा रही है. ओके, टेक योर टाइम, डू अलोंग विद मी. फिगर आउट कहाँ से ऊपर जा रही है, पकड़ के रखो. ये दिस इज क्लियर हाउ वी गेट दिस रिलेशन.
Yes, sir. Tan theta, right?
This is the value of tan theta. Why we need to do this? Because there are two variables. X is also changing, R is also changing. We can integrate only in one variable. So we have to replace, we have to find relation between R and X. Right? Substitute the value of small r as alpha X plus R1. And where alpha I have taken as R2 minus R1 divided by L. राइट, सो उसको इंटीग्रेट कर लेते हैं फ्रॉम जीरो टू एल. रो बाई पाई. अब इसका इंटीग्रेशन थोड़ा मैथमेटिकली मे बी 1/x² का इंटीग्रेशन होता है -1/x. सो 1/α(x+R1)² का इंटीग्रेशन हो जाएगा -1/α(x+R1) डिवाइड बाई द कोफिशियंट ऑफ x. हमने कोफिशियंट ऑफ x से डिवाइड कर दिया इंटीग्रेशन फॉर्म 0 टू l. रो डिवाइडेड बाई पाई टाइम्स अल्फा, ये हो गया -1/α(l+R1) -1/R1. अल्फा की वैल्यू सब्स्टिट्यूट कर लेते हैं फिर से. अल्फा क्या था, R2 - R1 डिवाइड बाई एल टाइम्स एल प्लस आर वन. बट आपको साथ में करना पड़ेगा, देखने में समझ नहीं आएगी मैथ ये. बट ये सारे क्वेश्चन आ चुके हैं एंड दैट इज वाई आई एम डूइंग दिस इन क्लास with you. R2 - R1/L (L+R1) और ये माइनस माइनस प्लस हो गया, एल एल गॉन. रो डिवाइडेड बाई पाई अल्फा -1/R2 + 1/R1 और एक अल्फा एल कहा गया. जो बाहर हमने अल्फा बाहर भी डिवाइड किया था उस अल्फा की वैल्यू रख दो. अल्फा आ गया R2 - R1 (L) और अंदर लिमिट अंदर एलसीएम लोगे तो R2 - R1/R1R2 आ जाएगा. R2 - R1 विल बी कैंसल्ड आउट. So it becomes rho L by pi times R1 R2. Rho L, that resistance becomes rho L divided by pi into R1 R2. Please check. Maths last में जाके simplify हो जाएगी, but हाँ इसमें थोड़ा आपको ध्यान देना है. Integration में 1/x² का integration होता था -1/x, but जब साथ में कुछ coefficient लगाओ according to coefficient rule, हमें पूरे function को बाद में coefficient से divide करना होगा. Right. बड़ा समझ आ गया ये मेहर नहीं. इनर रेडियस एक साइड रेडियस है R1, दूसरी साइड रेडियस है R2 और लेंथ है इसकी L. रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ सच वायर विल बी रो L बाय 5 टाइम्स R1 × R2. Understood?
Yes, sir.
The mathematics part. So, ठीक है, जिनको मैथ थोड़ी कम समझ में आ रही होगी, स्पेशली बायो बिट्स, यू कैन जस्ट लर्न दैट फाइनल रेजिस्टेंस इज दिस rho × L1 rho × L/π × R1 R2. सो अगर मैं यहाँ पे कोई बैटरी लगाई, then we have to find the current. The current in this wire I will be equal to just E by R according to the Ohm's law. Current से हम current density निकाल सकते हैं, current density से हम drift velocity निकाल सकते हैं, electric field calculate कर सकते हैं by using the same method. Right. डन सो इनके आप रेजिस्टेंस के मैंने एक और डीबी भी दी है जो हम करेंगे फ्राइडे क्लास में. ये जो हमने किया है दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट द रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ वेरिएबल क्रॉस सेक्शन वायर और डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ वायर. सो सिलेंड्रिकल वायर हॉलो सिलेंड्रिकल वायर एंड अनदर वर्ड वॉज the hollow spherical wire and the cylindrical wire having uniform non-uniform area increasing cross section. So please go through it. We'll continue from here with Friday class. We'll be having questions first and all of your doubts. Right? Okay then. Thank you.